ओके सो नाउ यस्टरडे वी हैव गॉन थ्रू थ्री डायमेंशनल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन. ओके सो वी हैव गॉन थ्रू ट्रांसलेशन, वी हैव गॉन थ्रू स्केलिंग, वी हैव गॉन थ्रू रोटेशन अबाउट एक्स, वी हैव गॉन थ्रू रोटेशन अबाउट वाई, वी हैव गॉन थ्रू रोटेशन अबाउट जेड. ओके सो these are the three dimensional transformation which we have already gone through. Okay, so now today's topic is mainly related to all three dimensional viewing. Okay, so first is orthographic projection. Okay, so this is axonometric type. So we are going to get there are various types in axonometric. We have a diametric, then trimetric, and then we also have isometric, and we have orthographic projections. Okay, so to understand this, I need to get into paint. Okay, so because here drawing utilities are limited. Okay, so just let me know whether my paint screen is visible. Come on, quickly everyone, just let me know whether paint screen is visible or not. Okay. So I'll try my best to draw the three-dimensional geometry. No, this is not the way. So line. To increase DPI of my mouse. Okay. So I just got the line. Okay. Then from here I will draw a y-axis. Okay, then from here I will draw z-axis. Okay, so now let's try some sort of geometry. Okay, I'm trying to build some sort of geometry here. Straight up, maybe somewhere here, then okay, so I may connect this. Great, so now rest of the thing I can erase. Okay, so now let's draw some sort of geometry, maybe rectangular parallelepiped. Okay, so I'm trying to draw a geometry. Okay, so basically it's a three-dimensional geometry which I am trying to draw. So maybe height I take it small. Okay, then from here this is the line. Okay, then from here maybe something like this. Okay, so now with eraser I will erase this much portion. Okay, so that's fairly fine. Okay, so some sort of box geometry I am getting it. Okay, and we have now three different axes. So not text. So this is my x-axis, this is my z-axis, and this is my y-axis. Okay, now I want an orthographic projection of this. So let's draw here orthographic projection. So this is line. Okay, it will not be up to exactly up to the same scale, but you have to understand that they are of same size. Okay, and my front view is going to be this. Okay, so this is my front view. Okay, so how I am going to get a front view? When I just look after from this direction, okay, and project onto XY plane. So projection is along XY plane. Okay, that means I'm trying to make Z coordinate equal to 0 of all points. Okay, this is what I am trying to do. So I just copy this. Okay, and go back to in the word, because here I can do in more what better way. Okay, this figure is very large, so I'll take the snipping shot. Instead of select all, I'll take this much only. I'll paste it. Okay, fine. So this is what I got into the world now. Word now, okay. So I can scroll down, and from this now I could write my basically orthographic projection matrix. So my front view matrix transformation, basically the front view matrix transformation, what I am going to get it, that is what I am going to write. So my front view transformation matrix, that is denoted by variable h, and that is equal to okay, what I want to do, I want to make the z coordinate 0, okay, and keep rest of the coordinate as it is. So this third line, which represents my z coordinate, which will be 0. So if I multiply this matrix to any coordinate, what I am going to get is its front view. Okay, so this is what, if I multiply to any of the points of or any of the geometry, then I am going to get a front view. So just let me know whether you understood this or not quickly. Okay, fine. So I got some replies. Okay, now let's move back to paint, and we will try to understand what is going to be a top view. Okay. So let's switch back to paint. Now I need to draw a top view, and my top view is going to be coming somewhere here, something like this. Okay, so now what I have to do here in this case is I have to rotate basically. I need to rotate about this x axis. So this object, whatever the cuboid shape you are getting, that you have to rotate about the x axis by angle 90 degree. So when you rotate, okay, so this side, so top view you are looking from this, okay, so this side will come in front. Okay, so if you now look after from this side, if this side come in front of this after rotating a 90 degree, you will see this object. Okay, after rotation of 90 degree, and you watch from this direction, you will see this object. Okay, so what remains after rotation is making it z coordinate 0. So for this we have to do two operation. First is rotation by angle 90 degree, and then z transformation, that is making z equal to 0. So these are the two operation. If I do it, I will get my top view. Okay, so just let me know whether you understood this or not. Okay, fine. So again, I just select this and copy, and now what I do, I just delete this. Image, and at the same location I'll paste a different image. Okay, so that is what now it is coming. Okay, so now I have to do rotation by 90 degrees and then I have to make 0. Okay, so therefore, and that is about X. So therefore here in this case my top view transformation matrix, okay, and that H will be equal to, this is what I have to get it. So I just write that. Okay, so we don't need a Y0, we need a Z0 because actually we are drawing on XY plane. So to get the orthographic view, okay, we are drawing, so what we see in front of our monitor screen is XY plane. Okay, so now in front of your monitor you just assume there is a cuboid available, okay, and I want to get a top view onto the monitor. So how I am going to get, I am going to rotate about my x-axis. So my top view comes in front of me, okay, it will come in front of me, but its projection will not be on monitor because it is not in a plane of monitor, it is in front of the monitor, okay, and that means it is having a Z direction, and therefore I have to make that Z0 so that its projection I could see on my monitor. Okay, so I hope this is clear, just let me know. Okay, so basically orthographic projections I am getting on XY plane only. Okay, so there is no other plane which is available on which I am getting orthographic projections. So for getting all kinds of orthographic projection, I need to make Z0, then only I can get a projection on XY plane. XY plane represents a plane on which my all the views are going to be there, only their location will be a different and their view will be different, that is the only challenge. So by rotating a 90 degrees about a x-axis, so here I'm going to get 1, okay, 0, 0, and then again 0, here 0, cos 90, okay, cos 90 is 0, then minus sin 90 is minus 1, then it is 0, okay, this is 0, then sin 90 is 1, and cos 90 is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is what I am going to get as my rotation matrix. So I misinterpreted this. So this is not H, okay. So this is my basically a rotation about X matrix, okay, and then I will also need a Z0 matrix. Okay, so Z0 will be equal to (1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0) and this will be 001. Okay, so this is what I am going to get it. Okay, then so if I see rotation about my x, so this is cos theta, cos 90 is 0, minus sin 90 is 1, sin 90 is 1 and cos 90 is 0. So that is how I got the matrix, this one Rx. And now of course if I want H, okay, last transformation is the first one, so my first Z equal to 0 matrix, okay, and into the first transformation is my last matrix into Rx. So this is how I am going to get my top view. Okay, so just let me know whether you understood this quickly. So quickly, have you understood the top view? Okay, so now I again go back to the what you say paint, okay, then we will try to see how to get the side view. Okay, so let us say I want maybe right hand side view, so my view I'll be trying to look from this direction, okay, and maybe my side view may be appearing like this. Okay, so here in this case, the what operation we have to do, so basically we have to rotate about y-axis. So once you rotate about y-axis, so the surface towards which I am looking from the right hand side, that will come in front, okay, or that will be parallel to my xy plane. If I rotate this whole object around y-axis by 90 degree, okay, so the plane which I am looking from the right hand side, that will be parallel to my xy plane, and then what I have to do, I have to make the z0, okay. So for this, what I have to do, I have to rotate, first thing is about y-axis, so this was about x-axis and this is about the y-axis by angle minus 90 degree, okay, and then finally I am going to have z equal to 0, okay. So this is how I am going to get my side view, right hand side view basically, okay. So this is how I am going to get the right hand side view, okay. So this is a pretty simple task, okay. So I just switch back to Word again. Okay, so my right hand side view, right hand side view, okay, so that matrix will be, I am here in this case representing by H, okay. So my last operation is z0, so 1 0 0 1 0 0 sorry this is 1 0 this is 0 0 0 0 0 0, and then this is 0 0, and finally 1. So this is my z0, okay, and then it will be rotation about y by minus what you say 90 degrees. So I could see what is the rotation about y-axis, okay, so rotation about y-axis cos theta, so this becomes 0. plus sin theta, so this becomes minus 1, and this become plus 1, and this becomes 0. Okay, so here in this case I have 0, 0, minus 1, 0, then I will have 0, 1, 0, 0, and then I will have 1, 0, 0, 0, and lastly I'll be having a 0, 0, 1. So this is my rotation about y by 90 degree, and this matrix even z0, and whatever I get, okay, that represents, with the help of this, that represents my right hand side view. Okay, so just let me know whether you understood this or not. Okay. Fine. So now we will go to the isometric projection. Okay, so I just need a clean new page. I hope this is the end. I have reached. Did not write the date, so I will just write a date. So today is 24/07/20. Okay, so I'll be having all the details what I am doing. Okay, so I take a new page so I can write in a more better way. So now we will see isometric projection, and then we are going to write a small program, okay, which gives me an isometric program. It's a very small program, already lot of thing already we have written. We have to write just this transformation matrix and multiply to that particular coordinate. I will get the isometric projections. Okay, so that is what the we have to do it. Okay, so let's switch back to the paint. Okay, so I can draw a isometric view. Okay, so I just select all and delete it. Okay, so I just draw a okay, leave it like this, and this is my z axis. Okay, so let's try to draw square. Okay, then so I'll be drawing a parallel to this of approximately same length. Yes. Good, and then from here vertically upwards. Okay, so this is my cube has been completed. Okay, so that is great. So in online teaching I will learn few new things, at least paint. Okay, so that is great. So I just write down my name of the axis, x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. Now, what is isometric? Isometric view. Okay, so view direction. Okay, or I or camera, whatever you want to say. Okay, so view direction, I direction, or camera direction makes equal angle with respect to x, y, and z axis. They make a equal angle. Okay, so what will be the probable direction? So from this origin, if I try to draw a line, okay, so I need to extend this. Hope it will be having a same direction. Yes, so this is what is the direction what I have drawn, and here my basically my eye will be situated, and this is my view direction. So if I am watching from this direction, okay, so it will make an same angle, okay, it make an same angle with respect to all the axes. So if I count this angle and then maybe this angle and maybe I just made some mistake pointing out the axis label. So this is my y axis and this is my z axis, okay, and with respect to this, so this all angle will be equal. So it is coming from origin and exactly passing through opposite corner of that particular cube, and that is my view direction, and it will be making an equal angle with respect to x and y axis. Okay, so this is how I am going to get it, and therefore now here in this case, what operation I have to do it to basically to get the my isometric view projection. So my eye has to be in this direction. Okay, so this direction means, so this is what is coming like this. Okay, so first I need to rotate this whole geometry. I need to rotate the geometry or my axis coordinate, whatever do you, either you want to do the transformation or mapping. So I need to rotate this by an angle 45 degree. So when I rotate it, my eye will be aligned to this particular edge. So this whatever the edge vertical is coming, okay, vertical edge, so my view will be aligned, okay, but it will be perpendicular to this. It will be perpendicular to this. Then what I have to do, I have to rotate again so as to get to this angle. Okay, and then this this rotation is about what you say y axis. Okay, so this is rotation about y axis. And then I need to rotate this. So this angle is I call as maybe theta or
Welcome and thank you for choosing freeconferencecall.com. You're helping people around the world communicate for free. There are 53 participants in the conference.
Okay, again, just let me know whether I am audible and my screen is visible. Okay. So now I fine. I don't know what has happened. Okay. So basically, my internet has also come back. Okay. So let's do it again. So this is what is the operation, what we are trying to do it. Okay. And this rotation is about x-axis. And this rotation is about x-axis. Okay. Because when you rotate by 45, so actually what you are trying to do, you are trying to have your view aligned with, this is my square. Okay. So you are trying to align like this. Okay. So this becomes my x-axis. This becomes my y-axis. And this edge, whatever I am seeing, is nothing but this edge. Okay, so they are same. Okay. So I call this as a A1 and maybe this also A1. So this and this edge are same. So this becomes X and this becomes Y. Okay. So next target is to have this RX rotation. Okay. So I can call this as a theta and this angle I know as a beta. Okay. So this is about Y rotation and this is about X rotation. Okay. So I use the same thing here and then I'll copy into the word later on. So what is my operation? Basically H will be equal to, okay, and this Rx by theta. So Rx is by theta, and if you do calculate, since it is a cube geometry, you can easily calculate theta equal to 35.24. Okay. So 1 0 0 0. Okay. And then it will become 0 cos of theta minus sin of theta 0 0 sin theta cos theta 0 0 0 1. This is what I am going to get. Okay, into multiplication of this. So this was my Rx operation. Rx operation. And now into my Ry operation. This is what I want. Okay. So Ry operation is my about y axis I want to rotate. So this is cos theta zero sin theta zero zero one zero zero, and about z I will have minus sin theta 0, cos theta 0, 0, 0, 1. So when you multiply this together, you are going to get a some sort of matrix, basically that represents your, what you say, orthographic, isometric view. So whenever you multiply or you provide this operation, you will get a isometric view operation. So I just copy paste the image. Okay, so this is what we are going to get. So I'm going to write here in this case that isometric transformation matrix. Okay, so my H will be equal to of course I'll have some multiplying factor outside. Okay, that will be 1 by root 6 outside. So root 3 0 minus root 3, so this will be, I think, so 1 2 1, this is root 2, and then it is minus root 2, and then again it is a root 2. Okay, so minus, so this is what is there, and then finally this will be 0 0 0 1 0 0 0, and to this common is 1 by root 6. Okay, so this is easy to remember, so you can verify after multiplying that you are going to get this matrix. So now to any point if you multiply this, you get the isometric view. What else remains is making the value of z equal to 0 for all points. Okay, one way is to not to use z coordinate in case of programming. So in programming we are always using a maybe x y coordinate only. Okay, so one way is to not to use z coordinate. Okay, use only x y coordinate, you multiply this to any point. Okay, so what I suggest you, this is your H matrix. Okay, you could create this as a H matrix. Okay, you can put down this value, roughly you can calculate this value, what is going to, I have written in this way because it is easy to remember, and then try to draw, so isometric axis. Okay, X, this will be your Y, and this will be your Z. So this was actually a programming topic, but because of limitation of time. Okay, next time we are going to do it, but there is nothing wrong in it to try on your own. So this coordinate is 0, origin 0 0, take this coordinate as a 0 0, okay, or all zeros, x y z 0. Okay, and take one more point here. Okay, so its coordinate is 200 comma 0 comma 0. Okay, and its coordinate, take one more point here, and its coordinate, so this is in three dimension. Okay, basically 0 200 comma 0, and take one more point here, and let's say its coordinate is 0 0 comma 200. So such four point you take it. Okay, and then you multiply with this H matrix. Okay, and then draw the line. So let's call this as O point, A point, B point, and C point, and then draw the line from OA, okay, then OB, and then OC. So you will get an isometric axis on your 2D plane. So whatever the canvas drawing you are using currently, so you will get a full isometric axis. So you could try this on your own, or the next time I'm going to explain in a short. Okay, so this unit is finished. So this is the last program what we are will be doing, and that will complete the this unit. Okay, so we are running parallelly in CAD unit 1 and unit 4. Okay, so these two units we are running parallelly. This is as a part of CAD lecture and this is as a part of FEM lecture. Okay, so fourth unit is common to CAD as well as finite element method. So we are running the fourth unit parallelly. Okay, so that you have to understand that we are suppose in a position of completing two units from the CAD, okay, and two units from FEM as well, almost. Okay, so four unit we are trying to complete it. You can check the syllabus. As soon as we complete our one dimensional problems, we'll complete the two units of FEM and we'll complete the two units of CAD even. Okay, so thank you.